Now, just a question. Would you ever board on a plane that hasn't been tested?
No. No. Mm-mm.
In a million years, you'd never risk your life, right? So it's the same thing with software. Bismillah, bismillah. What's going on, guys? Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Amigoscode. In this video, I want to talk to you about five concepts that you must know when you start to learn Java. And this is a two-part video. In the next video, I'm going to talk to you about things that you need in order to master the Java stack. So that one will be more comprehensive. But this one's still very important because I feel that I've been teaching a lot of people over the last year. And this is something that I need to address so that you understand exactly what you need to know in order to move forward. Now, as you know, Java is a big language with lots of concepts and keywords and a bunch of things that you need to understand, but hopefully I can break it down for you. If you're new to my channel, go ahead and literally take 1 second and subscribe. Also, give me a thumbs up so I can keep on recording these videos. Let me know what you want to see next by commenting down below. And if you're not part of the Amigoscode community, both Discord and private Facebook group, go ahead and join. Without further ado, let's kick off this video. So the first concept that you need to know, and I wouldn't say it's a concept, but it's a tool, and that is IntelliJ. Yes, IntelliJ. Or maybe NetBeans or Eclipse, if you use Eclipse. But I would say try and stay away from Eclipse and NetBeans because those are old school, and really professional Java software engineers, or majority of professional software engineers that I know, they use IntelliJ, and IntelliJ is by far the best IDE for the JVM. So you should also know how to use IntelliJ. Now, IntelliJ can do so much for you. And the worst thing is having a great tool, but not knowing how to take advantage of it. So take the time to learn IntelliJ. Luckily for you, on my website, I've got a course. So if I go to courses, so there is a course specifically for IntelliJ, which was released, I think it was last month, but I didn't actually promote it. But this course right here, there's a bunch of people enrolling right now. And I go over, and also there's a 30% coupon in there, but I go over basically everything you need to know in order to take advantage of IntelliJ. How to set up your development environment, how to use keyboard shortcuts, right? Because with the keyboard shortcuts, you can do so much. Things that maybe will take you 2-5 minutes, take you seconds. So IntelliJ, it's powerful, and you should know how to use this tool inside out. Moving on to the second thing that I want to talk to you is how the Java memory works. So I actually have a diagram which I've been recording for my brand new course, which is coming up very soon. And right here, so this is part of the course, by the way. And basically in this course, I teach about the call stack, frames, the memory stack, the heap, how objects are different from primitives, how they are stored, how the garbage collector works. Because as you know, like as you start, you know, creating variables, this and that, and also this, the string pool, which is quite important right here. But as you start to allocate variables and passing variables, whether it's by reference or by value, you need to have a clear understanding of what you are doing, right? So if you define a variable, what are you doing? And if you don't know what you're doing, then it can be really difficult. So I highly recommend you to learn about this. And actually, I'm going to record a video for YouTube just on this topic, because it's really important that you master how all of this works. The third concept that I want to talk to you is you should know the basics of the language, classes, objects, inheritance. You basically should have a clear foundation of the language. If you don't know how to create classes, how to create objects, how to link these objects together, then how do you go about start writing code? You don't, right? So also, like, for example, the static keyword, what does it mean, right? So as beginners, people will start using a bunch of static keywords, but without realizing, you know, what does it even mean to be static, right? So having a clear understanding of the foundations of objects, OOP basically, it's crucial. But one important one, which I need to stress out, is interfaces. You should program to an interface and not an implementation. And with that, you gain so much as you move into the world of design patterns, testing your applications, and much more. And in fact, I'm going to record a video for you teaching you how to program to an interface and not an implementation. So interfaces is a must. And obviously abstract classes, so that you can basically build reusable code and whatnot. But on this course right here, which I'm kind of almost finishing and will be part of a bootcamp, which I'm going to release very soon, by the way. Bootcamp, yes, it's going to be insane. So stay tuned for that. So I'm going to cover all of this. And all these diagrams that you see here, it's part of that. The fourth thing, which is really important for you to know, is data structures. Data structures. Now here, Java has the collections framework. And basically, I've done a video for free on YouTube where you can go and learn about the collections framework. I teach about arrays, array lists, 2D arrays, sets, maps, stacks, queues, and all of that stuff, right? So having an understanding of how they work, it's essential, and you must know. So these data structures are there to help you, because with programming, what we do, we just manipulate data. Now, if you don't know how to store that data and the efficient ways of manipulating that data, then you're gonna be in big trouble, right? Now, two data structures that I want you to focus, and trust me, you'll be using them most of the times, and they are lists and maps. So with those two, you can achieve pretty much anything you want, right? But having an understanding of the others is also important, because then you can be more selective on the data structure that you're going to use for a particular problem. Last but not least, number five, and you know that I love testing. Yes, testing. Test your code, because testing your code will teach you how to write better code. It's as simple as that, right? So sometimes we kind of write a bunch of code, we throw things together, but we don't know whether it works. Well, we think it works because we've just, you know, pressed the play button and it's running and we've tested that way. But one, like that is pure wasting time, and don't do that. I've done it myself, and that's because I didn't know how to test my code. But don't do that. Learn how to test your code, right? Especially unit testing and mocking. Obviously, there are other types of testing that you should be learning, but learn those two, because once you learn those two, then like literally you start to write better code. You're like, okay, so how do I, for example, mock this dependency? Oh crap, I'm not using dependency injection, so I cannot mock it. Bingo, you change that to a dependency injection, right? Or I'm using static keyword. Okay, so is there a reason for using static here? I don't even know why I'm talking like that, but is there even a reason for using a static keyword in here? Or am I using interfaces correctly? Abstract classes? And basically, like literally, test your code. Now, just a question. Would you ever board on a plane that hasn't been tested? So let's say you want to fly from London to New York, for example, right? And this is me coming in. Oh, I've got this brand new plane. I've tested it in my own way by just, you know, doing like manual testing and whatnot. And, you know, I tested it for 3 months, a brand new plane. Would you ever board on that plane? Never in a million years. You'd never risk your life. Right? So it's the same thing with software. When we build software, we are delivering it to real users. Now, I know that you might be saying, okay, so maybe I'm actually learning and all these, you know, little projects. It doesn't really matter. But trust me, you want to build the foundation correct. You want to build the foundation correct so that in the long term, you are a badass developer. This is it. Five concepts that you should and must know. If you enjoyed this video, please do let me know. Also, if there is anything that I've missed, but I think these were the five main ones since I've been teaching for the last year at boot camps and online as well. This is one of the things that I felt like people were struggling the most, and this is what I do recommend for you to focus on. But obviously, let me know if I've missed anything which you think that it's really important. But as I said, this is a part one. The second part, I'm going to actually talk about the Java stack, which is going to be like more advanced stuff, such as design patterns, JVM, Lambda, streams, immutability, and a bunch of other stuff like blocking, non-blocking, because you need to have a full understanding also distributed systems and basically the Java stuff, including Docker, Kubernetes, Terraform, AWS, and whatnot. But I'm going to cover that probably next week. So if you enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up. Literally just smash that like button. Let me know what you thought about this video. Comment down below. If you're not part of the Amigoscode community, go ahead and join both private Facebook group as well as Discord. So for now, I'll catch you on the next one. Assalamu alaikum. Why did I do this? Assalamu alaikum. Oh boy. Assalamu alaikum. See ya.